Today, our topic for study will be the legendary psychologist Abraham Maslow and Carl Rogers, or rather the famous concept of self-actualization. Its essence is directly related to the personal characteristics of a person and the development of his personality during life. The path to self-actualization is the desire to become the person we can become by nature, namely to reach the top of their potential, to achieve the full use of their talents and abilities. Consider Abraham Maslow's point of view. The American psychologist considered self-actualization to be the highest human need. And here there is a contradiction. And what if we imagine Maslow's pyramid of needs upside down? And then the true value of self-actualization will be justified. Its role should be central, extensive, and subordinate to all other needs. On the basis of this principle, a harmonious personality should be formed. Consider Carl Rogers' point of view, which is closely related to the previous one. Self-actualization is a natural disclosure of a person's natural potential in the presence of necessary conditions. Human nature has a tendency to growth and development. As a plant strives to be healthy, as a seed strives to become a tree, so a person must become a complete self-actualization person. 15 signs of self-actualization personality. Number 1. Adequate perception of reality. Self-actualization people are able to perceive the world around them, including other people, correctly and impartially. They see really as it is and are objective in perception. Number 2. Acceptance of self, others, and nature. People can accept themselves as they are. They are not overcritical of their shortcomings and weaknesses, nor are they burdened with excessive feelings of guilt, shame, and anxiety. Such people perceive their psychological nature with pleasure, feeling, and joy of love. Number 3. Spontaneity, simplicity, and naturalness. Is characterized by the absence of artificiality and desire to produce the effect. Their inner life, thoughts, and emotions are alien to conditionality. But this unconventionality doesn't mean that people constantly behave contrary to tradition. Number 4. Focus on the problem. Such persons are committed to some task, duty, vocation, or favorite work, most likely than life to work, not work to life. Number 5. The need for privacy. Maslow writes that self-actualizing personalities are in great need of privacy and solitude. Unfortunately, this quality of independence is often not accepted by society. Number 6. Autonomy, independence from culture and environment. Self-actualizing people are free to act, regardless of this physical and social environment. This autonomy allows you to rely on your potential and internal sources of growth. Number 7. Freshness of perception. Self-actualizing people have the ability to evaluate but the dignity of even the most ordinary events in life, while feeling novelty or pleasure and even ecstasy. Number 8. Peak or mystical experience. Maslow came to the conclusion that self-actualizing people have moments of strong will or high tension, as well as moments of relation, peace, and tranquility. Number 9. The public interest. Even when people are concerned or angry about the shortcoming of the human race, they share a deep sense of intimacy. They have a sincere desire to help their brethren become better. This aspiration is expressed by a feeling of compassion and love for humanity. Number 10. Deep interpersonal relationships. Self-actualizing people seek deeper and closer personal relationships. They tend to establish close contact with those who have similar character, talent, and abilities. Number 11. Democratic character. Such persons have no prejudice and respect other people, regardless of their gender, race, religion, age, profession, or status. They are also willing to learn from others without any desire from superiority or authoritarian tendencies. Number 12. Differentiation of means and purposes. The personality is more consistent and firm about what is right and what is wrong. There is a clear distinction between means and ends. People like to do things for the sake of the process. Number 13. A philosophical sense of humor. People with self-actualization prefer benevolent philosophical humor. They don't accept jokes that ridicule someone's inferiority, humiliating a person. Number 14. Creativity. Maslow noted that all self-actualizing people have the ability to be creative. Maslow spoke of spontaneous creativity, which is present in life as a natural way of expressing an observant, receptive, and vivaciously simple personality. Number 15. Resistance to popular culture. Self-actualizing people are in harmony with their culture, maintaining internal independence from it. They have autonomy and self-confidence, so their thinking and behavior is not amenable to social and cultural influence.